And now for your weekly dose of metal. Here are your hosts, Morgan Danielle and Mook El Blaze, on The Metal Experience.
Woo-woo! We just heard some Opeth, Demon of the Fall, Anthrax, NFL, and Metallica, Blackened. I'm Luke O'Blaze, my host Morgan Danielle, and we are here today with Armored Assault. As
we've got a man unplugged.
Oh, you unplugged yourself. I like how you tried to. He tried to plug in the plug into the other out plug.
What instrument do you play?
Guitar.
Okay, it would be a little bit different if you were the drummer and didn't know how the audio cables work, but you're a guitar player.
No excuse.
That's no excuse.
Why don't you guys?
Well, I just didn't know where the other out was.
Go ahead and introduce
That's
yourself.
That's what she said.
What you do on the band. What do you do on the
on
band?
On the band. I'm Tommy. I play
AKA
guitar.
AKA Hot Dog.
Yes, the Hot Dog.
Holy shit!
No!
Fucking Speed Freak just showed up.
They just mooned us through the window.
Oh, man. Haven't seen those dudes in forever.
That was awesome.
Now I just got scarred for life.
So,
Speed Freak
so
just
gay.
Ran up and put their bare butts on the
We're off
glass.
To a good start.
This is going to be a good show. Why don't you guys keep it going? What else? Who are you and what do you do in the band? And who's missing?
Try this again.
I'm Mark. I play guitar.
I'm Mark. They call me Chode.
Do we want to know why?
I don't even know
I'm
why.
I'm not going to go into that.
Oh.
It's kind of like a, you know how like in a prison you would call the huge guy tiny?
You've been raped a lot by your band members?
Yeah.
So what you're trying to say is you have a monster cock.
I'm not going to say that, but yeah.
But yeah.
And I play the drums.
With his monster cock. My name's Andy. I do vocals.
And who are we missing today?
Elliot Sick.
Elliot.
Well, you're missing out, Elliot. We're having fun without you. So tell us a little bit about what Armored Assault has been up to. I know you guys are recording a CD right now that you didn't bring music for tonight. How unfortunate for us.
That is correct.
So you've had the honor of hearing it before anybody. How's that going?
Good. I think last time we were here, Squeege just joined the band like maybe weeks before or something. So it's been going pretty well since then.
It's getting there. We're wrapping things up. We just finished up tracking finally, and we just got a little bit of more mixing and other bullshit to do, and then it'll be done.
And who are you recording with this time?
Our buddy Jeff at what the hell is he called?
Low Tech Labs.
And where's that at?
It is in Des Plaines.
A little
in an underground facility place that nobody knows the hideout to.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Underground. And was this the same person that you recorded the last CD with?
No, it is not.
No, last time we recorded with Nick Nativo in
In Mokina.
At the Nook.
Yeah, at the Nook.
So how many songs can we expect on this new album? Do we have a name for it?
It's five songs. And then, yeah, the name of the album is Call the Beast.
The Beast.
Call the Beast.
Call the Beast.
Call the Beast?
Call the
call,
get
call
it
the beast.
Right, Morgan.
1-800, call the Beast.
Okay. Call the Beast.
Yes.
Beast has an iPhone. You can text him.
Yeah. 24 hours a day, any day of the week, call the Beast.
What phone number can we call the Beast on?
666.
Oh, I was going to say 773-657-3341. Our phone lines are open. Call the Beast. Talk to Armored Assault.
Armorless Assault.
Armorless Assault.
That would be creepy.
For a second, I thought you said talk to Armor All.
That too. Talk to
that
Armor
too. All. I never get any guy names right. 773-657-3341. Call us and talk to Armored Assault and the Metal Experience.
So what have you guys been doing? What have you guys been up to since the last time you guys run?
Besides recording, obviously. He's not listening.
Baiting
real hard.
Just playing shows and jamming, writing new stuff, and drinking a lot.
Yeah, I was gonna say, just kind of going through the motion of everything. We've been doing a lot of shows in town. We're about to do a bunch of like out of town shows, not like too far out of town, but just in the Midwest. In March, we're playing in Indiana, which will be cool. We played out in Fort Wayne a bunch of times, and they always treat us well and always want us to come back. So it's really cool to have people that actually want you to come back.
When are you playing Fort Wayne?
It's March 14th.
Do you know who you're playing with? Are they Indiana bands?
We're playing with Testimony. Ooh, nice. We're playing with a band called Koheleth, and we're playing with a band called Born Under Burden.
Okay.
Yeah, some shit like that.
And then we're playing with some shit like that
the next night.
We're playing with them in Anderson.
I should learn their name.
Anderson, in Indiana, which is kind of by like Indianapolis. But we're playing with them, this band called Summon the Destroyer, and then band called Iron Diamond, which is actually the drummer from Skeleton Witch, I guess, does vocals, and it's like a King Diamond cover band or something. So
nice.
It'll be cool.
Oh, man.
we'll get drunk and listen to King Diamond songs, if anything, so it'll be pretty fucking sweet.
You guys have those two any more shows coming up? Those two set up right now.
That's pretty much it for March. I know April 8th we're playing at Reggie's with...
It's on my birthday, too.
Yeah. Ooh, happy birthday. Who's playing Reggie's?
It's us, and the headlining band is this band called King Parrot, which is...
Oh, my God.
No way.
Why?
Is that the band that just...
How much are these tickets?
No.
Are you selling tickets? My brother's got an obsession with this band.
No, it's not. Is it King Parrot? It's not the band with like a parrot.
Okay.
What is the name of that band?
I don't know, but it's ridiculous.
We should probably like Tutti Frutti or something.
Tutti Frutti.
But that and the band with the dogs for the vocals?
Oh, yeah.
Canius. Is that
band? Canius?
I've heard that one,
Are you guys selling tickets to the Reggie show?
No, I Damn know it. It's, I forget how much it is.
Will you be selling tickets for the Reggie show?
I think you can get them online.
That doesn't help me. I was just going to buy them off you. No, no money for armor to sell.
Sorry, guys. So
we don't like money, so it's cool.
So what has been, since the last time you guys have been on, you said you played a ton of shows. What's been the most memorable moment from that show or the most embarrassing moment from one of those shows?
Did your mullet get stuck in your instrument?
Oh, shit, there's been so many.
No, the mullet's been flowing freely. I can't think of anything embarrassing that's really happened lately.
Embarrassing or just awesome? Like, this dude showed me his dick. I don't know if that's awesome.
Well, that's just regular.
That's band practice pretty much every Tuesday and Thursday.
This is band practice right now.
We just saw some butts, so I guess.
Yeah.
We're
halfway there.
That was pretty cool.
I don't know. It was cool to play at the exit. I don't know. It's...
The show we were supposed to go to?
Yeah.
With Air Raid?
Yes.
Stupid ass fell asleep.
And then Morgan falls asleep, and I shake her. I'm like, I'm so comfortable.
I was like passed out. I'm so tired. I was like, what time is it? No, I'm done. I don't know what happened that day that
coma.
I was probably
candy
coma. You can blame that on a lot of my instances.
Dave, can you try and find the band with the parrot lead singer? and the canine lead singer.
That's relevant.
Yeah. I actually heard both of these recently, and it's like death metal, and then just dogs barking.
What?
And then there's
a
death
dumb
metal,
concept.
And then like just a parrot just making crazy.
Anybody
parrot
can make those songs. I could talk like a parrot.
Okay, the band is called Hatebeak.
Hatebeak.
Yeah. That's it.
Is it Hatebeak or Heatbeak?
Hatebeak. Can you play a quick snippet of something from Hatebeak?
Yeah, I can find something.
Oh my god, it's just. It's like,
okay, hold on. This one's called Birds Seek Vengeance.
Oh my god.
All right, skip through it.
The lyrics are just so fucking deep. This is like stupid people that took that Death Clock episode way too seriously about fish. Only being able to, like, understand the music. They're just like, nah, birds will just hear it, man. And they'll be like, fuck yeah, Judas Priest, Metallica, I could bark to this.
Dave, can you look up, what was the other one, Caninus?
Canius?
Canius or something?
wonder how they get that bird in a vocal booth.
Yeah, or I wonder if they play live shows ever.
Why?
You fucking put the, make noises, bird!
You put the bird on stage, he's either going to fly away or he's going to be stuck in a cage and rattling it the whole
They've
time.
They've got a little tiny whip to, like, fucking... Yeah.
Now! Make that sound I need for this point in the song.
It's so dumb.
The other one is literally, it's like death metal in the background and two dogs just
barking.
So it's
Caninus, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, found, yeah, there's actually a song, No right. Dogs, No Masters.
This is the dumbest concept.
No dogs, no masters. Oh, red crayon.
This is ridiculous. Thank you, Dave.
Man, I should get Harley to fucking record a song for us. My little fucking chihuahua shit.
Oh, good. You and Luca can bring your dogs over to play.
Oh, God.
It'd be a riot.
It's a little shit. Anyway, moving on. I'm wearing Chicago Bears themed Zubas tonight.
Zubas.
Heyo. Dave's rocking a fucking Green Ranger shirt.
Power Ranger shirt.
Hartford Whalers hat.
And a Whalers hat.
What
but
the
anyway,
fuck
enough
is
about
a whaler?
Dave and dogs and parrots. More about you guys.
He's wearing a tiger being mauling a sheep. What is that for? Do you know karate?
Yes.
You know karate.
It's to warn people on the street that I know karate.
Careful. This guy knows karate. Obviously.
And of course, Andy's wearing Ghostbusters for the sad Harold passing Ramis. Of an icon.
Harold Ramis. Is
pretty sweet.
Thing.
Rest in
it's
peace.
Pretty, I don't want to brag or anything, but it's pretty sweet.
Yeah, Ghostbusters, classic.
And my sweet 9-year-old hat.
So I'm guessing that puts kind of a kibosh on Ghostbusters 3.
No, Seth Rogen's.
I like that. I like
maybe
that
he'll
wordage.
Make a cameo.
Ooh.
Kibosh. That's a good one.
What?
What?
He said kibosh. Is that a real word, or did you just make that up?
No, it's a word.
Isn't that like a Japanese guy?
It is. Oh, it kind of puts a Japanese guy on that movie.
Kibosh.
All right. Well, let's hear an Armored Assault song, Mark. That chord that you were playing with before, that is meant for your iPod
the
that you are going
to
plug
tried to put
in
an
your music
in.
Into.
Shit. Technology.
So then what are we playing?
Up in the mean streets.
Just Wandering Soul, I guess. We'll start it out.
And what is this off of?
An iPod.
Live from Mark's
how
iPod.
Many gigs?
It's off the Dead Before Dawn EP that we put out a few years ago.
120 gigs? Woo!
I have 160. What?
All right, cool.
That's how much space this one song takes up. It's 120 gigs.
So what was the song again?
Wandering Soul.
Let's do it.
To the metal experience.
Did you say hookers and blow?
No, I said the metal experience.
That's not nearly as good.
Do you want a taco?
That's right, we're back with the metal experience. I'm Morgan Danielle with Luco Plays, and we're here with Armored Assault, who didn't bring new music, but the old stuff is still as good. What did we just hear?
Or is it?
Doing with
I'm sorry. Phone. I just saw. I thought those were buttons.
Stop touching. That's not yours.
I was like, I want to touch those buttons.
Oh my god.
Sorry guys. So what the? What did we just hear?
Are you stuck?
That's my massage.
He wishes.
Is that wandering soul?
Wandering soul.
All right. For those that want to call in, it is 773-657-3341. Call in.
Galaxy.
It's the metal experience. 773-657-3341. We are on until a little bit after 10 o'clock, so there's still time. All right, so Wandering Soul. Andy, what is Wandering Soul about?
What is it about?
Your microphone, you're not talking into it.
No, it's there.
It was in his crotch.
Yeah, no one touched that microphone until it's disinfected.
Wandering Soul's kind of just about, I don't know, crazy person, like psycho killer. It's very much about how one person can kind of have, like, everything kind of in his control, but still, like, not at all. I don't know. It's, it's shit, man. I think I said that last time. It's about stuff and things and shit.
It's shit.
Oh, my goodness.
So you guys have 5 songs coming out on the new CD. How many have you written? Is there more that you couldn't record that you didn't have time, or are you saving it?
There's one new one
that we're actually playing live and stuff that we're not we didn't record.
That's not that has been recorded, and we're working on some more new stuff that Mark actually wrote.
Ooh,
so yeah, we'll get to start to hear a different side of Armored Assault.
The red ass.
What have you written so far, Mark?
I have one completely finished song that we're in the process of learning right now. And I'm actually in the middle of working on another one right now. I don't know when that'll be done, but
what's the song that you fully wrote called?
It doesn't have a name. It's just guitar parts. I figured I'll let Andy write the lyrics and call it whatever the hell he wants.
It'll be about
It'll be about shit. It's gonna be about stuff and things.
Shit.
Yeah,
and stuff
that's a good metal song. Stuff and things.
So
things and what have you.
So Tommy, do you approve of his writing?
Yes.
Like, no, I fucking hate it.
Yeah.
We haven't told him, but we're not going to use
it. Yeah, he's just no longer going to be. No, it's fucking awesome.
This is the interview that I get fired in.
No, his writing's fucking badass. It's tough. The shit that he sent to me, I was actually kind of having a hard time learning it.
Who's been playing guitar longer?
Girl.
Mark, how long have you been playing?
I think I started when I was about 13,
So how many?
Ago.
How many years?
13 years. I started when I was 10, I think.
Okay.
I think Tommy? I've been playing for 14 years.
Okay, a year more, and you've tricked him. Ooh,
well, you know. You've stumped him.
It's I'm still actually kind of getting some of the parts down myself, but it's a little tricky. It's a lot of it's a notey song.
It's very 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 fucking notey, and I hate you for writing that fucking song. But it's gonna be awesome. We just got to sit down and hammer it all out, and it's kind of cool, kind of going in a little bit of a different direction. Kind of, sorta, and just add in another flavor to Armored Assault. So,
hearing it, I'm very glad that I don't play guitar.
what has been the influences that you guys have been taking to write this album? Who have you been listening to?
Or have there been any?
Not all at once.
I just locked myself in a room and beat on my guitar.
You okay there, Mark? You look like you should be in a straitjacket, rocking back and forth right now.
Yes. He is on the inside.
Yeah, he looks like mentally disturbed. I'm like, I'm worried.
Wild cherry Pepsi.
Tell that studio audience to
pipe down.
Simmer down a little bit over there.
So, any influences for the album, or are you just kind of whatever?
I don't know.
You just shit and stuff.
Kind of like with the last one. There's some parts that are kind of way different than other parts. And
yeah, we kind of cover a lot of ground, I think. Kind of don't really stick to a certain, subgenre or anything. It's just metal, and they get a little bit of everything, I guess. I don't know what it sounds like.
What CD do you have in your CD player right now, or the first band that you've been listening to on your iPod? Like, what are you listening to in your car, Andy?
I don't know. I listen to a lot of stuff.
Right now, if I was to turn your car on, what CD is in there?
It would probably be
Spice Girls.
I don't want to answer that question.
It'd probably be like Devin Townsend or...
I'm talking about like right at the second what is in your CD player.
There's an iPod in my car, so okay. it'd be iPod.
Dancing Queen's
iPod. Right?
It'd be iPod.
All right.
But again, it's usually like Devin Townsend. I listen to Clutch. I'm a huge Clutch fan. I know I like a lot of sludgy metal and shit too, as well as like fast and progressive shit. I love Revocation and bands like that.
I've had that new Protest of Heroes CD in my CD player.
Are you going on March 8th?
Quite a bit. Yeah, I'm going? Planning on it.
Yeah.
It's
like
that's what this show. Is,
That's a protest.
That's a protest? What's on the back?
It says Protest the Hero.
Oh, it says I know karate.
I know karate.
So
Protest the Hero knows karate.
Tommy, so what is in your
what iPod? Is in your CD players?
iPod CD.
What is in mine right now in my car? Killswitch Engage is
Woo!
Alive or Just Breathing.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Right. I love Killswitch. Thank you, Tommy.
I love that album so much.
Okay, that's at least a good album.
It is a good album with their old singer.
Do you like the new one?
No.
Damn it.
I didn't like it either.
I like.
It's fucking terrible.
All right. Last but not least, Mark.
I had a Soilwork CD in my car.
Which one? Stabbing it's the Drama like is the best one?
No, I love that, but it was some new one.
Oh,
it's like their newest
Infinity?
One. I had it in there.
It's
and
so
I,
good.
I threw it out on Milwaukee Avenue.
Deliberately?
I didn't.
What the fuck? That was a dual album. You have two CDs. Where's the other one?
It didn't come with maybe it's a different album then.
Okay, because the new one that came
know,
out last year out. Was a two album.
And the Great Divide was
not that. That's a good
new.
One.
I don't know then. That's all
it
I
doesn't
know.
Have the old drummer.
Morgan, what's in your car, Morgan?
Right now?
Yeah.
We were listening to Home of the Brave on the way here.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
From Indiana. Local band. Yep. But before that, it was Born of Osiris's The Discovery. Was it Discovery?
Actually, I really want to know what Dave, what are you listening to right now in your car?
Canius.
Dancing
No, I can't remember.
Hey,
I'll put my iPod.
Dave, what's in it? You play it off an iPod or do you have a CD player?
No, I have an iPod. I have a CD player too, but I got tired of carrying my CDs, so I finally got
one. Lester.
So yeah, last song I listened to before I got here was Gang Control by Leftover Crack.
Oh my goodness.
That's awesome.
And
good
I'm
job.
Listening to Meshuggah.
Yay.
That fucking video, Tom, that you showed me. That Leonardo DiCaprio.
Oh my god.
Luco can't stop watching
it. It's amazing.
Over and over. It's so perfect.
I saw everyone posting it and I didn't watch it, and then he showed it to me, and it's fucking.
There's a 10-minute version of that scene just replayed over and over and over, and
it's
10.
Dave, can you pull that up?
Yes.
The Meshuggah Faces. Leonardo DiCaprio. No, Faces of Meshuggah.
Wolf on Wall Street.
It's Isn't it
Face on Wall Street?
Meshuggah on Wall Street or some shit like
it's
that?
It's really weird.
It's only like 15 seconds, but it's
What's the so weird is 15 like seconds. That chick in the video is doing that hand motion of
that
like dick, dick, dick,
like,
dick.
Dicks in my dick, mouth.
Yeah. I'm just like, it just looks so. She's the only like female in the office, dude. Anybody else notice that? She's wearing pink.
Yeah. Everyone's in black and white. She's in pink, like, dicks in my mouth.
Right? He's so angry.
Turn this up.
I love that everyone's fucking pounding on
like
their chest.
Like, who pounds on their chest in the middle of it? That dude is so happy.
It looks like a fucking cult beat.
And that fucking face he makes. Yeah. This one, the dicks in my mouth. Dicks. He's like, dicks. Oh, my God. The face he makes right at the end, I'm like, that's totally.
Did anybody see that movie that they can describe to me what happened in that office?
I didn't.
Damn it.
We have it. We just have it. We have it illegally.
Don't tell anybody.
Don't tell anyone. But we haven't watched it yet.
Dave, look that up while you're at it. Weird movie metal mashups. I want to see if there's any other scenes that are that awesome.
But that was, I seriously, for 15 seconds, I was like, all right, replay.
It was more than 15 seconds. It was more like 10 minutes, all right, and he could have just watched like 10 seconds.
This is
seconds.
So good.
And then I saw someone post an article that like, they were trying to get Leonardo DiCaprio to do that with them live.
Oh my God, that'd be hilarious.
Like for Bonnaroo or some shit, they
oh,
were trying
man,
to get him to
fucking
do it.
Awesome.
And realistically, though, like, how long would that fucking last?
15 seconds?
Yeah. Him just, like, being up there going, like, looking like he's yelling and not actually doing
and making
anything.
The face.
All right, Leo, thanks. You can go home now.
Yeah.
The face was so perfect in that, too, though. That was what made it. It was the faces he was making. I was like, oh, my God, that's him.
People banging on their chests. Crazy.
What is this one, Dave?
Oh, it's just called Movie Metal Mashup. I don't know what.
Skip through it a little bit. I'm not hard yet.
There's no man, no woman in here that shall stand alone.
Today we Pacific are Rim.
Sparta!
Slow motion movies and breakdowns are perfect together.
Is this just one song? Breakdown on Gandalf. I love it.
How long is this?
Way too long.
Nice.
All right, now change tempo. Different. Oh, come on. This is gay.
Let's throw this. I was just saying, into another breakdown.
Did you just hear that? He hit him and he went, bitch. Nobody do that again, Dave. Do that again. That was perfect timing. That was really good editing. I liked it a lot.
That was a great bitch.
That was really good. That was great. That was strong.
It was a perfect
bitch. It really was.
It was
perfect
so
bitch.
Strong.
Go.
Oh.
Yes.
Skip through it. A...
That dude got knocked out that
John
horse.
McClane. John McClane.
Wait for it. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
Who is this? This looks very familiar. I've seen this video. What the fuck? Anybody?
Why so
serious?
It's been
be
like
pretty bored.
14 breakdowns.
Yes, it has.
Every new movie just changes on the breakdown.
Chimera or something.
I am
really? Come on! This is this.
I'm making waffles.
That was Shrek.
I know this song! Damn it. Oh, this is. This is
Thanks
like,
for watching!
Alright, that was
Thanks,
fun.
Thanks,
look, look up YouTube Heavy Metal, see what comes up. There's only interesting things on the internet, so you can find anything.
The best is really that Nirvana fucking mashup with Never Gonna Give You Up. What's his fucking name?
Never Gonna Give You
Up. Rick Astley?
Rick Astley.
Yeah.
That's an awesome
mashup. That, there's what? There's the Iron Maiden one with the monkeys. You seen that one?
I don't think I've seen that one.
It's, what is it? It's the Trooper and,
Hey, Hey, Where the Monkeys?
Hey, yeah, we're the so. Monkeys. Da na 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 na. The monkeys.
They totally sync up. It's ridiculous.
That's funny. Well, while we think of more YouTube videos to look up, Dave?
Could I speak to the drug dealer of the house, please?
Let's hear it from the soundboard.
Okay.
God, I'm sick. Exactly. So, a band was just formed not too long ago called The Great Collapse. It features the members of Strike Anywhere, Rise Against, and Comeback Kid.
Woo!
They streamed their song Blood, Bread, and Roses.
Sorry.
I'm guessing he gets told that a lot. Not
what is
things.
What is this song called?
Blood, Bread, and Roses.
Mm-hmm. Play this for us.
That's all I hear. This is garbage. Turn
what
this
is
off.
It called? Blood, Bread?
And Roses.
Blood, Bread, and Roses. Mm. What a terrible sandwich.
You guys got that blood bread?
Blood, comma, Bread, and Roses, yeah.
I hear Tim.
I hear garbage. Let's find something else.
Yeah, why are we listening to this?
I wanted to hear it. Damn it.
But anyway, yeah, that's their new band called Great Collapse. EP is called We Are the Wasted Class of the Western Story.
And they're dead.
Anyway, and then as far as streaming new songs, Comeback Kid streamed a new song called Wasted Arrows.
Oh, Comeback Kid.
I like Comeback Kid. Shut up.
Cool
good.
Story, bro.
They just did a show with Sabalba that I wish I would have gone to.
Never heard of them. Is this Comeback Kid? I don't remember them sounding like this. Oh, well, all right. What else you got, Woo! Dave?
Anyway, that new album comes out March 4th on Victory.
Buying it.
Yeah,
so maybe.
Yeah, everybody hates Victory, though.
Yeah.
Victory.
So
I almost worked for them, and then I didn't.
Morgan almost got hired.
I almost
to work
did.
At Victory Records.
And then I denied him.
And then she said, uh-uh.
Fuck that. I want to work at Victory Auto Records instead.
There you go.
Okay.
Bensonville.
Continue.
So, I almost forgot, like, this is a thing. Bless the Fall is going to go
is
on
a
tour.
Thing.
Yeah, we heard.
You almost forgot this is a thing?
I forgot they were even a band still.
Oh, God.
Does anyone else remember them? Yeah, no.
Didn't when they were good.
So. I don't know what that is,
yeah,
I think.
I have no idea.
All right, Dave, continue.
Asking Alexandra also released a video for a Nine Inch Nails cover.
Yeah. Whoa!
I hate...
Whoa!
What song?
Please play closer. This. Please play this. I need to hear this.
There's a...
Are there videos of them squatting on dicks to this?
No, it's like a chicken like lingerie.
Ooh, play this video. Put this up.
Why can't we see this, Dave?
Yeah.
All right, we'll do.
If we're going to have to listen to this.
I mean, we need some
chicken
visuals.
Chicken lingerie.
Yeah, right?
Chicken?
There's a
Watch
chicken
it be
and
the
lingerie?
Vocalist. Chicken and lingerie.
Skip through this.
Oh, dear God.
Doesn't even sound like a proper cover. It just sounds like it's like a karaoke version.
Yeah, seriously.
All right, turn this off.
Yeah.
I don't know. Those guys get way more publicity than they should.
I liked them when their first album came out.
I liked them when never.
But anyway, yeah, uh-huh. That's on the new Punk Goes Metal Volume 2 or whatever.
Oh, I love the Punk Gobis Metal CDs. They are
Gobis.
So good.
The Gobis. The Punk Gobis Metal.
Is she going to take her clothes off yet? What's going on?
I have no idea. I'm just going to leave that playing because it looks kind of weird.
Yeah, do that.
Those zebras get naked?
Zebras are naked.
Are they already naked?
Zebras are always naked.
What do they look like without their stripes?
Actually, they look black. If you shaved a zebra, it's all black. It's black skin underneath.
You Why do you know that? When did you shave a zebra?
I didn't. I read a fact online.
I could write any fact online. Like, you shave a zebra and they're rainbow colored skin.
I Googled it.
What else you got for us, Dave?
Memphis Mayfire stream a new song, Sleepless Nights.
I like Memphis Mayfire. They're awesome. Continue. Yeah.
Anything else?
Tim Lambesis pled guilty.
Do you have anything good on that list of stuff?
Sentenced to 9 years, 9 years in prison. Tim Lambesis will be going to prison.
They haven't sentenced him yet, but it can be up to 9 years.
Oh.
Yeah, but he pled guilty, so that's kind of weird. But whatever. I thought he would just keep denying it.
We kind of knew he was guilty.
You know, because you talked to him, right, in his personal life.
That was another fact that she looked up.
That was another fact. But when you shaved Tim Lambesis's head, he's rainbow colored underneath, right?
No. No.
Anything else, Dave?
I'll say, you know, I think we still have his. I think I can still find his, Tim Lambesis's phone number.
I'm pretty sure he's.
I don't know if he's got access to a phone.
I know Devin Townsend raised like 300% of a goal for an album that he's
300%.
That's a lot of percent.
Yeah.
What was he looking to raise?
I don't.
About 100%.
I forget what the total was.
Oh my goodness, that was a good one.
That was a good comedy one.
Well, let's, Dave, you have anything else for us?
Yeah, Danzig's in the studio working on a new album.
Yep.
You mean a new pile of garbage.
Ooh.
Literally, did you hear his last album? I listened to the whole thing. I wanted to suicide myself during every song.
Suicide myself.
It was so terrible. It was terrible. Anyway, he should just give up writing new stuff and just get back with the Misfits and do some stuff like that. That's the only way he's going to claim to fame back into, you know, society and be accepted. Anything else, Dave?
Yeah, Texas in July.
Yes.
They had replaced your lead singer, Alex, with JT, Cavi, and are about to start working on a new album.
Wonderful.
Who's the new vocalist? I need to know
JT Cavi?
Justin Timberlake?
Justin Timberlake.
Justin Timberlake Cavi?
Look up what bands he's been in. I need to know these things. Their album was so good. No.
Anything else, Dave?
Do you have anything else on your list that we can shit
all
over?
What? Killswitch?
Killswitch is announcing a spring tour.
Yes! No, they already announced it. They're not coming to Chicago. They're staying mostly in like the southern states and the East Coast.
Wonderful.
Perfect.
I can dream.
Perfect. I don't have to go Mayhem see Killswitch again.
Mayhem Fest. Yes. They're going to probably be announced for Mayhem. So I will go and watch him. And we get to meet him. Yay!
Odd combination.
If I ever got to meet him, I'd be like, hey, you guys are good, but I mean, not as good as
I've already met them. They're so awesome. You're going to love them.
Just walk up and be like, what happened, guys?
You used to be cool. You don't say things like that. Don't do that.
I wouldn't say any of that stuff.
That should always be like your first question to major bands. Just be like, so what happened?
What went wrong?
They're like, we're on our first album. What do you mean? Like, yeah.
No,
yeah.
I heard the demos.
Yeah.
What happened?
All right. One last thing. Hell Yeah and Avenged Sevenfold are going on tour.
Nope. That's a terrible idea. Hell no, we won't go.
I feel like what's his face? Chad Gray and Vinnie Paul are like butt buddies now, man. I don't know. I see all these videos of them online together, and they're...
Chad Gray, is totally that the fucking guitarist for Mudvayne?
No, he's the vocalist.
Which they just got rid of the guitarist for Hell Yeah. And
he was in Nothing Face too, right?
He was in Mudvayne.
Wait, they got rid of the dude from Mudvayne in Hell Yeah?
Yeah, the guitarist.
So who rejoined? Well,
they had two guitarists, didn't they?
The guy from Nothing Face.
I have no idea. Honestly, I don't know.
The guy from Nothing Face was in it, and then the guy from Mudvayne.
I highly doubt they were like, listen, I know we're in Mudvayne, but go fuck yourself and you're out of the band. He was probably like, listen, I got to beat my wife on a more of a regular basis.
Whoa.
So I'm going to have to, you know,
this is what happens.
This really happens. This is Rockstar Lifestyle. Tim Lambesis is, you know.
Luco just hasn't gotten caught yet.
Prime example.
What?
But yeah, I wear long sleeves all the time. No idea why Avenged is going on tour with Hell Yeah, but I guess that will be a good tour if you're in.
Because they covered that Pantera.
That'll be a
Pantera
terrible,
walk
terrible.
Vinny's
tour.
In
don't
Hell
go
Yeah,
to that.
And they're gonna probably play Walk. And
they don't need any more of your money. Yeah. They're set for
it's
life.
It's for money. That's the only reason why.
Yeah. No.
Anything else for us, David?
They need money to raise
for Matt Shadows to cut his hair. Looks terrible.
That's pretty much the end of it. But the funniest thing I think is they're starting off in Dawson's Creek, British Columbia. So
great
I thought that was kind of crappy.
Start.
Are you a big fan or?
No, I do not like Avenged Sevenfold. I know someone
he
who
doesn't get it.
Yeah, I got Huge it. Fan.
Yeah, anyway. I got it. I'm just not a big fan. Okay.
So are you?
Oh, Joshua Jackson,
James Vanderbeek.
Fucking love you, James Vanderbeek. James Vandercunt.
All right, let's go into more Armored Assault.
Yeah, let's hear another.
And you can call in 773-657-3341. Just
what else
wait
you got
till
on,
after the song.
What else you got on that 120 gig?
You have to plug it in order to play it, Mark.
Five songs.
That's a trick.
Should we just go down the list?
Shall we just.
You okay over there, Mark?
I'm trying to think of what to play.
There's so many choices. There's
takes
like
three.
At least
what
four.
Would you
of
like
them
to
looking
hear?
Over.
We hardly heard your voice.
What songs are on this album?
Can we hear Dead Before Dawn? Or Dead By... Yes. What was
let's
it?
Let's do Dead By yes. Dawn.
Dead by Dawn.
This one's
the
called...
title track of the CD.
This one's called Bed Before Dawn.
Bed Before Dawn.
Bed Before Dawn.
Bed.
Shit and stuff and whatnot.
Bed Before Dawn.
Just play the damn song.
Now, back to the metal experience.
Did you say hookers and blow?
No, I said the metal experience.
That's not nearly as good. Do you want a
taco? I would love a taco, actually.
Me too. And we are back, the metal experience. Local Blaze, Morgan Danielle. We're here with Armored Assault. And what was that badass motherfucker we just heard?
Dead Before Dawn.
Dead Before Dawn! Yeah. So, Andy...
What's it about?
No, I was just asking you how you're doing. What's
good,
going
actually.
On?
No, seriously, should I tell you what it's about?
Yeah.
It's about shit.
I want to know.
No, it's it's basically about just like slaughter and killing people. It's about death.
Before dawn.
Before the time
okay.
of dawn.
Before okay. about 6:50, you know. Right? 6:50. What's sunrise now?
Yeah, I don't know.
It's right before the sun comes up.
All right, well.
It's actually during.
But yeah, it's about pretty much kind of like an army of people who go around
doing
killing
stuff.
People if you don't join them. If you don't join them, they'll kill you.
Yeah, that sounds legit. That sounds legit.
You don't join us, we kill you. Sounds
pretty much.
All right. Dead. Good summary. Thanks for that info.
By about 7 a.m.
So while we're all chomping on gum, let's play confessional. Since Tommy and Mark have been in the band for the shortest amount of time.
Wait, what?
No?
Nope.
Who's been in the band the least?
Mark.
Yeah, I said Mark.
Squeege, but you said Tommy.
You said Tommy and Mark.
And I'm pretty sure Tommy.
You guys are the newest members, are you not?
I'm pretty sure I started this band in high school.
Oh.
Yeah, newest member, duh.
Got confused.
Well, let's play How Well Do You Know New Mark.
Yeah. How well do you know new Mark? Tom?
Oh, shit.
This one's on you.
All right.
What's his favorite breakfast food?
Ooh.
Are we talking fast food? Like if we're going through McDonald's?
Anything.
Or like, okay.
Like what am I on a daily basis for breakfast?
Yes.
On the average day?
You should know this answer, Mark.
On the average day? I don't fucking know.
Don't you wake up next to him every day?
Yo,
cook him breakfast?
My Italian sausage.
I don't know. Mark seems like a Cheerios kind of guy. Cheerios?
Well, I would say I'm a cereal kind of guy, but I don't stick to one cereal.
Shit.
So just cereal in general?
This one's for Tommy, not for you, Andy. You're next.
I don't fucking know what he eats.
I don't know what he eats. All right, what's... All right.
What's his favorite movie? What's Mark's favorite movie?
What's Mark's favorite rape position?
Oh my god!
Like, what's his favorite position to be raped in?
Rape others?
Do the raping in?
Oh my god!
Wait, that still sounds confusing. Do the raping in?
I'm just gonna make it clear that I'm not a rapist.
But have you been raped? I think that's the real question.
He's been raped. Mark's adjusting himself.
Feel free to call in and talk to Mark about rape.
I just want to make it clear.
773-657-3341. Let's take things up a notch and have you guys ask the questions to these guys.
I got a
question.
How
well do we know Mark? What you got, Dave?
Is he a full-on rapist?
I didn't know there were degrees. I'm just a beginner. No. I'm not very good at tearing the clothes off yet.
You're a novice rapist.
I'm at the advanced level. I could get in there fucking real quick.
In all seriousness, Tom.
What's his favorite rapist? What's his favorite?
To make it easier on you, what's his favorite movie?
His favorite movie?
Featuring the act of rape.
His favorite movie's Ghost.
Is it really Ghost?
No, it's not.
You fail at knowing your band member.
I can't even really pinpoint what my favorite.
Well, you're fucking terrible.
There's so many good movies out there. But it's definitely not Ghost, I'll tell you that.
Is Ghost in the top five?
Not even.
The top 500.
I don't even know if
have you seen Ghost?
I've sat through like 30 minutes of Ghost at a time.
Just the pottery scene.
Yeah. That's the only good part anyway.
On repeat. Rewind that, Mom. I gotta watch that again. I'm getting so hot over here.
She's making the best vase ever.
Okay. Andy, this one's for you. What is Mark's favorite band?
Armored Assault.
Oh,
got it, guys.
Shit.
You guys don't know this dude very well.
How long have you been in the band, Mark?
Be like a year.
Summer will be a year.
Oh, my
yeah,
God.
Yeah, so fuck off, all right, guys? Relax. I'm, man, that's kind of tough.
You're a big Revocation fan.
I do.
This
like
isn't
Revocation.
For you, Tom. You failed.
See, we're answering. We're answering each other's questions.
We're a fan. We're helping each other out.
You don't have lifelines. I didn't grant you lifelines.
Listen, we share beds, questions, food.
Questions in bed.
Rape.
Food in bed.
Food. Yes. In bed.
You guys share your rape. That's.
Yeah, we do, of course.
There you go.
It's not fun unless you share.
Yeah, there you go.
It's not fun for the other person.
That's called a gangbang. We've taken it to a whole new level.
Gang rape.
There you go.
What's going
on?
What's happening?
I'm going to say...
There's fucking music in the background. Fucking killing me, man.
I'm going to say maybe Protest the Hero.
Oh.
Is this true?
At the exact
hold on, there's a phone call.
Yes.
Pause everything. Ooh. This doesn't happen too often, folks.
In big letters.
Yeah, it does.
This is the Metal Experience. Who are we speaking with?
Hey, it's Rob.
Hi, Rob.
What's going on, Morgan, Luco?
What's going on? Rob, what's your favorite rape position?
Oh, my God.
Dude, my favorite rape position is the one with Luco's fucking legs behind his ears.
Yeah!
Oh, my fucking, God. Ew.
Dude, Toad looks like a total fucking rapist.
He's shaking his head yes in approval.
Monster cock and all.
He's stroking his mustache.
I just wanted to call in. I got a couple minutes trying to dodge these lot lizards out here in rural Illinois.
Lot lizards? What the fuck are you talking about?
Those are ladies of the night that hang out at the truck stops.
You got some ladies at a night working out here.
Ask them what their favorite rape position is.
I was going to say, yeah.
What are you doing at a truck stop?
Yeah, what are you doing?
How do you like to take it?
I can't hear you guys.
What are you doing at a truck stop?
I had to stop and take a dump. I've been driving for like 8 hours.
Oh, my God. Hey, sorry, babe. I asked.
Hey, babe, you want to get with me? I just took a dump.
Hey.
My hemorrhoids are flaring up.
When nature calls, you got to answer.
That's
true. You're going to fucking feel like shit.
I pooped in the Slam Internet Radio toilet last week, and it was rough. So.
It did not look pretty in there.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
It looks like a rape scene happened in there.
It actually
a rape scene with poop.
And I pooped in there. And it was not a good poop either.
Rape.
It was a poop rape on the toilet.
All right, Rob, let's get off of this conversation for serious. How you doing?
I'm good. I just wanted to call in and show some support for the boys.
Hell yeah.
I think I've seen every show they've had for like the last 2 months.
Wow. Yeah, we mentioned the show earlier at the exit, which you actually helped put together.
Yeah, well, I did sound. I think Randy put it together. You know, to see anything, but just want to show our support. I think I've seen you guys at Jody Exit, Brower House.
Yeah, you were just at our show on Saturday, man. It was awesome having you there.
Yeah, I had to leave once a dude started tucking his dick and getting on stage. I was like,
yeah, that was Clay.
What happened?
It's never really a show unless there's
some
dick joke.
That was Clay.
Some dude sucked his own dick on
stage?
Whoa,
now that's a completely different show.
Oh, my God.
Our buddy Clay, the singer from Skank, decided to tuck his dick between his legs and wave our armored assault flag around us.
If you've ever seen Silence of the Lambs.
Then he pulled his pants down after he tucked his dick.
And then he what?
Oh, yeah.
He pulled his pants down while he was tucking his dick. I was like, oh, I'm done.
That's when you decide to call it a night.
You're like, hey, nice wiener there. Hey, you got a real nice wiener over there.
I actually did not see that happen. And it happened.
This song fucking rules,
this
though.
This is a good song. We should come out to
totally
this.
Cover
dude.
This.
Dude. Could be the song that we come out to.
Ooh.
We've
my God.
We've been having this discussion at band practice for like the last month. Like
would
every
you
time
fuck
we
me?
Jam. I'd fuck me.
You can be the flag bearer, Rob. Tuck
I'll
that dick between
Randy.
Your legs.
But, I wanted to say, you know, I've been seeing Armored Assault play more of their new stuff, a little more experimental, a little different, sounded good, and you guys kick ass live, and that Air Raid, you guys and the Air Raid together, I think is one of my favorite shows, local shows ever.
Yeah.
That was a fucking awesome show.
Morgan. Sorry.
Yeah, you guys missed a good one.
That's Morgan, 100% Morgan. I was ready to go, I was all hocked up on Mountain Dew, ready to get jiggy with it, and then Morgan.
Nah, that's awesome, because we've known those guys for a long time, too. I mean,
yes, it's coming up. This is what we're talking about.
What movie is this?
Silence of the Lambs.
Come on.
I've never seen this movie.
What?
Oh, my God.
That's it. Go stand in the corner. It looks like David Lee Roth.
It's Toad raping someone.
Might as well jump.
I hear like 5 voices at the same time. I just pictured Toad raping Luco.
That could happen.
All right, but awesome show, guys, and can't wait to see you guys live again.
Again,
oh, yeah, man. Thank you.
I can't wait to rape you.
Thanks for all the support, brother.
I love
brother.
You, Rob.
I will rape
later,
you, Rob.
Later, guys.
See you, man.
Bye.
The kisses were from Mark.
What's this dude doing?
Oh, man, yeah.
He's tucking his shit between his legs.
Why?
He wants to be a lady. He wants to be a lady.
Oh, the puppy.
I want a puppy. You all guys right. are so mesmerized at this. The scene.
Well, let's move on and let's hear the unsigned band pick of the week and take this dude's dick off.
Put the lotion in the fucking basket.
Whoa.
He's very. What's that word I'm looking for?
Gay.
Rape.
Rapey.
He's very rapey when that scene comes on. All right, Dave, let's do it. Whenever you're ready, Dave.
Now it's time for
Dave.
Hey man, look what I found.
Only on the Metal Experience.
And you know what's funny? The band that is that we're gonna play here in a little bit, we're actually really stoked that we're playing their songs. And now after, and they're like, "Oh yeah, we'll definitely be listening." And now we've been talking about rape. They're probably like, "What the fuck?"
We're sorry, guys.
We don't
want to
be affiliated with
ever.
This. Sorry, guys. But this week, unfortunately, unfortunately for them. Rape. from Seattle, Washington.
A Christian rock band.
I don't know if they're Christian or not, but anyway. A Sense of Gravity from Seattle, Washington. This is off their new album. I believe it's down up for download right now.
Well, the song
Travail?
Is. The album's not out yet. Travail is the name of the CD. Wraith is the name of the song.
Yeah, I was getting there, woman.
Well,
did you say it's Rape is the name of the song?
It's not
Rape. The name of the album that's not out yet, but up for download,
yeah,
Travail, with the song Wraith. Let's do it.
Oh.
This divide is realized in
Thank you.
I've never heard this song.
What is wrong with you?
What is this? What is this off of? Is it off of something or just?
It's off of an album.
It's not like in some movie or something or anything.
I'm sure it's in. I'm sure it's in a lot of pornos too.
Ooh.
Have you never heard this song before?
Oh, I listen to metal. I don't listen to queer shit like this.
Whoa.
I don't listen to no queer music. America, red meat. Shotguns and Budweiser.
You would love the video to this song.
Oh my god, I bet I would. Is it a bunch of black ladies with big butts?
No, it's like a bunch of country dudes in a bar while Genuine's dancing. Oh. It's what? On the fucking monitor right there.
What is this song called?
Well, anyway.
Pony.
You want to turn this down just a titty bit there? We just heard A Sense of Gravity from Seattle, Washington. That was a badass. And their album is up for pre-sale. It's not out yet. The album... Travail, hopefully I'm pronouncing that right, which I probably am not, but it's spelled T-R-A-V-A-I-L, so, you know, dictionary.com that or something. And with the song Wraith, that was pretty badass. Check them out. But we are back in the studio with Armored Assault, also known as the Red Ass.
Woo.
And we're down one member. One member had to go pee-pees.
Yep.
Explain for those that don't know the red ass that we've been referring
the
to.
The red ass is a stupid nickname we got from Speed Freak.
nice laugh.
We were playing a show at Ye Olde Town Inn, and the Dre race board, I think I erased their name, so it said P Freak. And they erased our name and retaliated with red ass. And it stuck.
And now, isn't also someone's house called the Red Ass Manor?
Yes.
We don't know them, though. This is the weird part.
That's perfect.
No, the house that me and Pindy are running out is the Red Ass Manor.
Nice. Do you have, like, red butts or anything anywhere? Or it's just
baboon momentums?
Anyone have? No, on our hoodie, we have...
Yeah, I'm not wearing it.
We have a little fucking baboon.
A red-assed baboon.
He's not little.
Well, yeah,
he's pretty
kinda
big.
That's what she said.
Nice.
But he's got two A's. He's got an A on each butt cheek. But
speaking of which, you took pictures that you gave us the last time you were here of this chick in armored assault, well, underwear with an armored assault sticker on it, holding guns behind her back. Whose
mom
were we
whose
looking
mom
at?
Was
that?
That
was me.
That was
Mark, actually.
Yeah, that was actually
that
was Mark.
Really?
Yeah, he's got a really
he has a nice tight
ass.
Butt. After
you
he's
were totally lying to me, right?
Minutes.
No, he does a
that,
lot.
That
he
was
does,
totally you?
He does a lot of squats.
You're seriously fucking with me?
I do a lot of squat thrusts.
If that was you, I've been convinced that was a chick the whole time.
His lunges.
Don't you feel horrible now?
I feel terrible.
You got a nice little girl butt.
I've been...
Did I miss Pony?
Yeah, you missed Pony.
That picture is used on our... we have a collage of everything, like stickers or pins or...
I don't know what she's talking about.
like stamps or from
she makes these things. She's like, hey, look at this. I'm like, ah, oh, real cool. Fucking get the fuck out of my way. I'm trying
I
to watch Predator.
I glued that picture onto that board. I was handing out pictures to people going, check out this chick's ass with this armored assault sticker. You're going to like hanging this up.
And now...
Little be
known,
it was a man.
Yeah, it's totally Mark.
I'm gonna rip all those up
now.
I'm gonna jerk out off to him twice as much now. So there you go. Well, anyway, why don't we do a? We found an instrumental, live instrumental, a song.
Yeah, if you go to our Reverb page, Reverb Nation,
you
Reverb,
left two
our Reverb
green
page.
Ones in this bag. That's all that's left.
So we anyway. Raped your gum.
Raped it.
Raped. Yeah.
No more double bubble.
We have a whole bunch of. Live tracks that we did at
Ye Olde Town Inn.
It's from I can't remember. It's a while back.
A while ago,
but
that was when Rob was still playing lead.
Yeah, so it's a bunch of stuff that's not even on that last CD.
Era.
So it's like yes. This song, which is our instrumental song you were talking about earlier. Armored Assault's on there. I think God of War's on there. There's a whole bunch of old songs that we haven't played in
forever.
Yeah,
probably since like that show.
Yeah.
Now this was the story because we said this off air, but this was before we met you guys, you know, we've heard of you guys from different bands and stuff, but you know, we know those guys and stuff. And we're like, oh, we'll try
to
get
bought tickets
show.
Off of them.
Oh, we bought tickets off you, but anyway, we were talking. It doesn't matter.
It was all funny because when we showed up to Mojo's, Pindy's like surrounded by people like a king on a throne in this huge bench up at the balcony of Mojo's. I'm like, buddy. I'm intimidated to approach this dude. Like, he's got his posse with him and everything. It's like, you want to come on our show? He's like, yeah, whatever. Just okay, send me an email. We'll set it up.
I got a phone call right now from one of the members of Sense of Gravity.
What?
He'd like to say thank you, so I'll put him on.
Hell oh, yeah. Experience. Who's this?
Hey, it's Brandon from A Sense of Gravity.
What's going on, dude?
Hey, I just wanted to say thank you for playing the first track from our new album, which I should let you know is actually already out right now.
Nice! Oh, the Facebook lied to me.
Sorry, I said rape so many times before leading up to playing, and I was like, oh man, I totally forgot we're... But it's all in good fun.
No, it was great. It really added to the atmosphere. Of
yeah,
the
no, this guy loves rape.
He's a rape advocate. All
right, ignore cool. them. They're just cruel human beings.
We're all on the same page, brother.
Yeah, I think so. But, yeah, that was it. I just want to say thank you so much.
Absolutely.
You don't want to talk about rape.
You know, the whole rape thing is a little controversial, so I'm going to skip that one. But, you know, it's all good.
Well, you guys are awesome. Keep kicking ass out there and keep us updated on upcoming things you guys got going. We'll announce them for you.
And come to Chicago. We need to see you out here.
Yeah. That'd be bad.
I may just do that one day. You never know.
Well, rock and roll. Well, thank you again for calling in.
Cheers, guys. Have a great one.
You too.
Bye.
All right.
Bye.
And we have.
That was fucking awesome.
Yeah. That doesn't happen too often.
So what I was saying was we were upstairs and we were talking with members of some other band. We were at Mojo's and I was in the middle of a conversation with someone when you guys were playing this song Armageddon, which is like an 8 minute long instrumental. Am I correct? Uh-huh. And in mid sentence, I just stopped. I said, hold on. I got to check this band out.
Were we talking to Emma and Justin from Eviscutorium?
I don't know. It doesn't matter because it wasn't important because I was like, oh, my God. And then I walked over. I watched from that song on to the rest of the set, and I was just like jaw open like, yes.
That was
That's awesome that you found a live version of it because I was actually asking if you guys were recording it because I fucking love that song. But I'm pretty stoked to hear it again.
And honestly, this probably sounds better than the garbage basement recording that we have. So this is actually a really good live recording of it.
Well, let's do it. The Armored Assault with the song Armageddon.
Yeah!
And now, back to the Metal Experience.
Did you say hookers and blow?
No, I said the Metal Experience.
That's not nearly as good.
Woo!
Well, there and we go. That was awesome.
We just heard some more Armored Assault. We heard Live Armageddon.
Live Armageddon.
And then what was the other track we heard?
There's only dying here.
What was that about, Andy?
Shit and things. And
stuff.
Yeah, of course.
I don't know, just how it's kind of what the song title is. It has to do with a lot of just...
dying here and
dying
there.
And
dying here, that dying there, dying everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, that.
Yeah,
you're
yeah,
so
pretty
full
much.
Of information.
I am.
Full of something.
My
full
dick.
Of shit.
Oh my goodness,
my chode.
Kidding.
Well, Morgan, I think
I was going to ask them really fast, what other shows do you have coming up, just to remind people?
That wasn't really fast.
Yeah, that was actually like
kind of slow.
A normal
well,
average pace.
What
ask
time
it really
would
fast.
You like
say it really fast.
Say it really fast and we'll answer it.
What shows you got coming up?
Pindy?
Too fast.
It's too fast.
Let's see.
Check Facebook.
We
on your
will
phone.
Be playing.
I'm trying to
We'll be playing Fort Wayne, Indiana on March 14th, as well as Anderson, Indiana on March 15th.
Anderson, Indiana.
And then we're going to be at Reggie's on April 8th, which is a Tuesday for Tom's birthday.
It's my birthday.
Birthday.
Hard to believe you're already almost 18.
I'm going to get so fucking wasted that night.
Friday,
awesome.
April 18th, we're playing at the Wisco in Madison, Wisconsin. Then like May, the very beginning of May the 3rd, we're playing, that Saturday at Hattricks, with No Conviction. They're from Chicago, but that's in
Kenosha. When is this happening?
That's in May.
May.
No Conviction's coming on the show soon, aren't they?
Shh, it's not confirmed yet.
Oh no, shh. I lied.
I have to talk to them Thursday.
And then, yeah, Friday the 23rd, we're playing at Yodi in Mount Prospect with, couple bands from out of state. I forget all the bands' names. Psychosis, Convalescence. But they're coming in. And then after that, we're playing in Griffith, Indiana.
Whoa, whoa,
Griffith, Illa, Indiana.
Illa, Indiana.
Illa, Indiana.
It's like just over the border, though. That's Saturday, May 31st. We're playing at Sopranos with Air Raid and Testimony.
It's going to be a fucking awesome show.
Yeah, no, that'll be a fun one.
All right, and with that, you can still call in 773-657-3341. I know somebody just asked me for their for the number to call in, so 773-657-3341. Until that phone rings, let's do this.
Let's talk rape.
The local roundup with Morgan on the Metal Experience.
Rape not included. Okay, so starting out with the local roundup. Check out Biomimic. They're looking for a keyboard player. Depremacy, looking for a drummer. Hate Storm Annihilation is in need of a bassist. And Worm just announced that they're looking for a drummer. I got word from Kimmy from the Metal Deli that she now has merch available on her website. And anyone that wears a t-shirt to the Days of the Doomed show in June, it's all weekend from June 20th through the 22nd up in Milwaukee. Maybe it's June 20th and 21st, Friday and Saturday in Milwaukee. If she sees you wearing one of her shirts, then she will buy you a drink.
Ooh.
Check out that little Ooh. Number.
What's their website? Oh, yeah. You can find that at themetalexperience.com.
All the links
under
are
the
up
support
there.
Page, you'll find Hell Kimmy yeah. in the Metal Deli. I'll link to her website.
Yep. Quake from Illinois has just released their song Counterproduction from their upcoming EP to be released this summer. Check it out on their Facebook page and YouTube. All the Way Alive from Lake County, Illinois has a new single called I Am Human. You can download their free EP, When Skies Are Gray, from their Facebook page. For $18, you can get a t-shirt and a ticket to see Ooh. Active Destruction open for The Absence at Penny Road Pub on March 13th. Free shipping.
I'm wearing an Active Destruction t-shirt right now.
We saw them God. Play Davern's Tavern in Justice this past weekend. They were fucking awesome.
That's fucking Johnny Five's band.
Yeah, Johnny yeah. Bravo.
Johnny Bravo.
We met
with Nigel Bravo. We met the Bravo mom. She is hilarious.
Oh, man. She's an awesome,
she
awesome chick.
She definitely is a woman that speaks her mind, and it was awesome. So next time Active Destruction comes on, we will have a special guest. Mrs. Bravo.
We believe, yeah, we asked her if she would come on the show next
time.
She's
like, you got to ask our my sons. They'll probably say no. I asked Nigel straight up, and he's like, okay. So I gave her the thumbs up, and it's a go.
So most likely, Mom will be on the show. That'll be pretty funny.
Yeah, it was awesome. And then we also saw another band that night play. What were they called, Luco? Fierce Atmosphere?
Fierce Atmospheres.
They were pretty awesome, too, so we're expecting to hear back from them. Also, Matt Wolf from Skullfogger has put together a mighty fine mixtape featuring some of Chicago's finest rock and metal bands.
You could still buy tapes?
Mixtape. I don't know if he released it on a tape, but it's definitely available. You guys are on it.
We are.
You guys
know about this. And there's, you can download it.
14 different bands.
Yep.
Local Chicago bands on it.
Beyond Death, Miles from Exile, Something Beautiful, Never We See, Mexican Werewolf, The Alder, Kingstep, and more is on it. So definitely check that out. Do you guys have a link to that on your Facebook or website too?
I know we've posted it and all that stuff. I don't know where it is. There's a whole bunch of crap on our Facebook page, so who knows.
All right. Well, it's
somewhere on there.
Definitely check it out. Definitely check out Skullfogger. Their Facebook page should have it. They're coming on the show too. I believe it's June. I'm just going to check to verify.
Oh my goodness.
I'm pretty sure. Okay, it's definitely June. I'll know a date next time. It's on my flash drive. Dave can look it up. It's on my flash drive. Dave, look up my band lineup.
It's going to be like August.
And give me the date. No,
like
August isn't
week.
Booked yet.
It was a week ago.
Let me know when Skullfugger's on when you pull up that list.
Skullfugger.
Of Wolves preparing to hit the studio. Check out their Facebook page and give them a like. They're coming back on our show April 7th.
Hey-o.
The Darksiders are almost finished recording their new album and have released their first shows of 2014. So definitely check out their Facebook page for those updates as to when they'll play near a city near you. Dave, what day is Skullfogger coming?
Skullfogger, June 24th.
June 24th, Skullfogger.
Day after my birthday!
What? Okay. Sunday on Corey Rocks Your World, Mine Enemies Fall will be on with her. They'll be on our show May 13th.
Hey-o.
So definitely check that out. Corey Rocks Your World on Facebook page has all the links to where you can hear her show.
Or
on our website.
TheMetalExperience.com has all that good stuff.
And definitely check out The Alliance Printing, the official printer of The Metal Experience, Corey Rocks Your World, MHX Radio, and The Metal Deli. All, where can you find it, Luco?
TheMetalExperience.com.
Yeah, check out the support page. We've got all cool links that you can
people you want to work with in the scene.
Absolutely.
Is this like a wrestling intro? Is the music?
No, this was done by Orion 9. This is
This is Mighty Boner Hammer, something like that. I can't remember the name.
Triple H entrance theme or something.
It's maybe something like that.
Maybe. Well, thank you guys for coming on. It was an honor having you guys back. I wish you guys had music, new music.
Man, I was so waiting.
I know that,
for that new
CD. When you guys booked this, you were like, "Oh, we'll have a new CD out."
ETA
lied to me, Pindy.
Nothing ever really goes as planned.
Whoops.
When can we expect to see the new Air Raid stuff?
Air Raid. This is Armored Assault.
When can we hear the new Air Raid stuff? That you guys just had a show with them. I'm asking. When are they going to have new stuff out?
That was awesome way to cover your ass. That was horrible.
When a show with them and stuff.
Yeah. Armored Assault stuff coming out. And if you do know when Air Raid's putting stuff out, I'd like to know that too.
I'll find out and let you know.
Sweet.
We don't really have a specific date yet.
We're hoping within like the next 2 weeks. To
at least
done.
Have stuff to like send you guys and kind of preview it to everyone. And
then hopefully within the next like 4 weeks to like month and a half, we'll have like an actual physical
people can come out and pick up and
do you
all
guys
that.
Are you guys gonna do you have artwork and stuff set up for
yeah.
it?
Yeah, that's
ooh,
all that's
who did
all
the artwork?
All done. We just got
a guy who's been doing our artwork. He didn't do the last CD, but he's been doing all of our t-shirt designs and all that,
which are fucking awesome, by the way.
Yeah,
he does an amazing fucking job.
It's this guy on Facebook, he's under Maggot Meister. But
Maggot Meister,
he does a website, it's called allthingsrotten.com, and he has a bunch of awesome artwork. He's done all sorts of bands, like Children of Bodom, Hyrax, and a bunch of killer bands he's done artwork for, and he's come through for us every time.
Yeah,
like,
Children
great.
Of Bodom and Hyrax.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like Hyrex, the local band Hyrex?
No, the like California thrash band or whatever they're. I forget where they're from.
Oh, that's what I was gonna say. Because we had. Oh, look at he's got this weird looking Jason figure in his right hand corner. He's super super skinny looking. That's
he's got a very long neck.
He's got a very long neck. And wait a minute, hold on. You guys are going to be rockin' Chicago this week. Am I wrong or right?
Yeah, we're doing show with Miles from Exile. They're going to be on there too, doing an interview. And
we
and,
will also not have the new CD for that.
Yeah.
Oh, see, and you guys were on Corey Rocks Your World last week.
We did have new music for her.
No. Whoa!
What?
You bring that shit here first.
We brought it there and just like, no one else.
So when, how far along with the recording process, we were talking outside, how far along are you guys on the recording process?
Everything's done and tracked.
Everything's tracked, guitars, bass, drums, vocals. We just got to sit down and mix everything and master it. And we still have a couple gang vocal parts we need to do.
Which, nothing like good old gang vocals.
Yeah, so we'll put something on Facebook when we're ready to do that, and basically whoever wants to come and
they can be a part of our CD,
sing on the fucking album, they can.
We do have a phone call. Patch him through, Dave. Hello, you're on with the Metal Experience. Who will this be?
What's happening?
Yo, what's good?
I think this is Everything Must Die. Am I wrong?
That's a yes.
Woo!
We're seeing you guys Thursday at Cobra Lounge. Very excited.
Awesome. Yeah. Very cool.
What are you guys doing? You're probably all in your living room right now.
We're practicing. Yeah,
what's the living room?
Oh, yeah, we are in the living room. We're at the rehearsal spot. What's going on? I'm in the show.
What's up?
Working hard or hardly working?
Drinking harder, being a hipster.
So do you guys want to talk about rape or what? Because the other guy did not seem into talking about rape.
We were just about to play Rape Band, actually, and we took a break. We got text.
We were like, speaking of Rape Band, let's see what Luco's doing.
Thank you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I love you guys. So what's the show coming up this Thursday? Where are you guys playing and all the good stuff that we will be at? I'll let you announce it.
All right. Well, we're playing the Cobra Lounge this Thursday, and Vic's Drum Shop is doing a showcase for us, so we're the only band playing. Vic's Drum Shop does it once a month. You know, they're great. They support a lot of bands. And so we're going to be there. We're going to play at least an hour's worth of music.
Nice.
We have 2 hours of music ready if they want to play.
Oh, my God. Nice.
It's going to be fun. It's only $5 to get in. You know, the money goes to the band, which is cool. And, you know, they have to have a sound guy, bartenders, all that stuff. It's going to be a blast. So if you guys can make it out, it'd be really cool.
We will be there. We're looking forward to it. And I can't wait to watch 2 hours worth of Everything Must Die.
Hey, dude. Yeah, man, it's going to be a great time. You know, we're super looking forward to it. We're
super looking forward. Now,
slamming some beers, you know.
Absolutely. And,
but, you know, we wanted to plug that. But, we wanted to say what's up to our brothers in Armored Assault, too.
Hell yeah.
First and foremost, and it's awesome you guys are doing a show for them, or doing a... radio broadcast with them. It's great.
Absolutely. We love these dudes.
Yeah, they're really talented. And
they're full of great love.
You guys should have been our Valentines.
There's a reason you see a lot of Armored Assault t-shirts rocking out there for sure. You know?
Oh, yeah. We've got them.
I think our same guy did the same logo. You guys had Chris Horst Studios?
I don't know what his name is. It's like Andres Baklaklak.
It's some Croatian.
I saw
dude.
That lettering and I thought it was similar to the guy who did ours.
No, they just copied you.
Yeah.
No, that's fine. We just copied someone else.
Well, we'll definitely be seeing you Thursday. Thank you guys for calling in and get back to practicing in your rape van.
All right, cool.
Tell Little Ryan. Bye, guys. Tell Little Ryan I said hi. Luco wants to get raped so bad. God.
He just wants to hear Big Brother, Little Brother.
Oh, man.
Big Brother, Little Brother.
very mad at Noodle Brother. Noodle Brother did a good thing.
Oh my god. You guys are awesome.
You guys are so funny.
Well, we will see you on Thursday, and thanks for.
Luca's an honorary big brother, surrogate.
Oh my god.
Perfect. Well, thank you guys for calling in. We will see you guys this Thursday.
Okay. Bye. Later.
I love you.
Rape.
Rape.
Healthy.
Oh my god.
Oh,
so
you got off the phone there pretty quick.
Before before we wrap this up, you guys have merch and stuff available too. Why don't you go ahead and tell all the peoples what you got? What
we have butt plugs.
All sorts of shit.
also just a bunch of shit.
Everything with us is shit. Songs are shit. Merch is shit.
It's all shit.
We got
tears of shit. What?
It's good air raid.
That's good air raid.
Speaking of air raid, do you guys know when they're coming out with new stuff? Like, I can't wait.
Go fuck yourself.
Now we have a bunch of shirts. Again, like you were saying, we have there's zombie shirts out there with
which are badass. Those shirts. Yeah, no, I have one of those, and I love it.
I got one of those.
We both have one of those.
What? We came out with those before Mark joined the band, but it's the four of us.
Sorry,
all
Mark,
fucking,
you're not on the show.
It's a shame.
Are you going to add him in?
We've discussed it, but
are
I don't know.
Releasing a shirt?
We're gonna do new shirts when the album comes out and all that. I mean, we have a whole bunch of ideas
designs.
And stuff. Yeah,
designs.
And then yeah, there's the Skull Tank shirt which is out there, and then
Whoa.
We have.
Oh yeah, Skull Tank. I was thinking a tank top.
No.
Which if you had a tank top, I don't have that yet.
Nope.
Summer's coming though.
Mm. Yeah, no, definitely. Once the CD comes out, that's kind of why we've been holding to that.
Armored Assault scarfs would be pretty sweet. Not
have
gonna
an
lie.
A on each
yeah.
end.
Yeah, I like.
There you go.
Yeah,
everyone can look like cool pilots.
Ooh,
as opposed to a not cool pilot.
Yeah,
you're a nerdy pilot.
And you guys still have those CDs available?
No.
We're out of physical copies again.
You guys, no. How many did
you
guys have? You
had so many fucking copies. When we were at the Devin Townsend show, Luco just kept grabbing them. I'm like, you got to leave some. And he's like, they got plenty. Have you seen that pile?
Yeah. You guys,
take.
Yeah,
I'm like,
we had 1,000, and now we don't have any.
That's good, though.
That's
that
really good.
Just so you know, I didn't just take them to be like, look at this massive collection of the same CD I have.
Sweet coasters.
Definitely
easy to alphabetize.
We handed all of those out for you. I don't think we even have any more.
No, we don't. Handed, we
I don't.
Have
I don't even
I
have
say,
a
I
copy
don't think
of it.
I do.
I don't have. I don't own.
How many copies
copy.
Have you been hiding?
I said I don't think I do. I.
They're all under his bed. He never gave them away.
Hoarding them.
I've got 500.
I lied, guys. They're right here.
eBay, bitches.
Yeah.
No, but it was like I did try and save a few, and then every so often you'd get the people who were like, so can I get a CD? I'm like, well, yeah, I really want you to have a fucking CD, but I want this fucking CD, goddammit. And that's how they're all gone.
Yeah.
Well, that's awesome. We're looking very forward to the new album when you guys finally release it and all your
upcoming
shows.
And give us
shows.
Those updates and we will announce them when
we'll
you guys...
No, like, we'll be sure to let you know when Air Raid's got new material.
And when Air Raid's got new material. You guys are probably having a release show also for the new CD.
Yeah, we haven't booked that yet, like an official
one or
anything.
They have to figure out when they're going to release
well,
it.
No,
we
I know.
Yeah. We have to
they tell me it's Sunday,
said,
but it's
said,
more likely to be a month from next Sunday.
Let us know about that too. We'll announce it and hopefully we can make it out.
And next week on the show, we do have Oxblood coming. Should be nice. Awesome. And then after that, Lucifist is going to be driving in from Indiana.
And we saw Oxblood.
We saw Oxblood with Tonson.
And Air Raid.
And Air Raid.
There you go.
And when's the next
time? So we
time?
Were there.
So, yeah.
So you were there. You were there. And when's the next time we get to be graced with the presence of the mullet on TV at a Hawks game?
At a Hawks game. Oh,
or at a hot
you
dog
got any
suit.
Tickets? You got any tickets for any games this season?
No. I don't think. No, I haven't gone. No, I went to one this year.
Which so, one did you go to? He doesn't even know.
The backstory of really this is we're watching a Hawks game, and during intermission,
Tom's so
you know,
creepy
they go
looking.
Out into the hallway
he just
area.
He does his best to stare up, but he's so drunk in a hot dog
in the 100 section, and you know, they talk about it, and they have a bunch of fans in the background for those you know who don't watch Hawks. Hockey or the Hawks or whatever.
Hockey.
Hawkey. And you see a dude standing off to the right, in a fucking hot dog suit.
and all my buddies were like eating a hot dog.
We're looking. I'm like, look at this fucking beers. Look at this fucking guy wearing a hot dog suit. And we're looking, you know, and then he starts eating a hot dog. So he's eating a hot dog. We're in a
it's
hot
like
dog
cannibalism.
Suit, slamming beer. And I'm like, I fucking know that guy. I'm like, he's in one of the bands we had on the show.
We've seen him twice now.
Yeah.
I've done it a bunch of times.
But that's the backstory of the hot dog suit at the UC.
Yeah.
I'll let you guys know when I'm doing
Andy,
it again.
Andy, when are you going out in a hamburger costume?
Oh, God. Steve Conroy remembers him, but probably...
Oh, yeah, dude.
Fucking guy in the hot dog suit.
Dude, me and Stevie Conroy, we're like best buddies now.
I'd say he'll probably never admit it in person, but I was there, I think, when he even didn't... At that training camp thing, I think he was there, and he fucking...
Wait, you were at training camp this year?
No, this was... Was it 2 years ago? 2 years ago. It was, oh, for, okay. It was for Chris's birthday. It was for Isaac's birthday. I was drunk.
I think it might have been the year they won the cup in 2010. Was it? Or the year after? I don't fucking know. Dude, we were there.
We were there, and we were getting fucking hammered because it was our buddy Chris's birthday.
And it was like $5 to get in and just watch him fucking
It was
fuck
early
around
too.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Training camp is awesome. It's $5, and you could sit anywhere you want.
Yeah, we got hammered, sat in the fucking... first section
in the seats.
Yeah,
we sat down and we watched practice. It was amazing.
They scrimmaged. It was a good scrimmage.
It was a really great scrimmage between
scrimmages
them.
Between players. Them players.
I think we saw like Patrick Kane's little brother play.
No,
or some
it was
shit.
Taves's younger brother.
Oh yeah, I remember when they were bringing him up.
Yeah, I don't know what happened with
and
him.
And like,
I don't know if he's still in Rockford or. I have no idea. Ask Matt Wolf.
Living in the shadow.
He knows the whole HOSA news.
And with that, what are we going to go out listening to?
We have one more track left.
We have one more track. Why do you keep unplugging the iPod? We're going to keep listening off of it.
Oh, two more.
Two more left.
Well,
so what song do you want to hear? Choose the best.
What song do you guys want to hear?
Well, which one do you guys got?
How much time do we have?
One song. Choose wisely.
Well, one is like 10 minutes long and one is like 5. Snatch.
All right.
Snatch Express.
Good night.
This is Snatch Express.
See you next week.
All aboard.
Assault.
Get ready for Oxblood.
Good night.